So the fine folks at Clip Pro grade plays on a scale of 1 to 5 stars. Now, as you can assume and presume, 5 stars means a play is really good. But typically it's saved for like the best of the best of the best. That's a 5-star play if I've ever seen one. So shout out to Luca. And if you go in here, let's see. Let's change the teams to the Mavs only. What are the 5-star plays in Clip Pro? 3-pointer by Luca. All right, let's actually watch these.
KP comes all the way out to the logo. Here's a switch. It's Luca against Josh Richardson. Left side of the floor. Luca's three is a ring. Again, it's
I would grade that 5 stars. Personally, I would grade that 5 stars. Okay, I agree with that. That's a good rating. It's a good rating. All right, what's the next 5-star play? 3-pointer by Luca. Okay.
Here we go. Cleveland into Luca. Luca. He got it. He got it. He got it. Is it a 2 or 3? We got to wait to see.
Okay. I agree on that. I think that's a 5-star play too. I agree. That's good judgment by Clip Pro. All right, what's the next 5-star play? 3-pointer by Luka. Okay.
Doncic, down to 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Doncic for the win. Oh yeah! Luka Doncic!
I'm sensing Doncic, a theme here.
Down to 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Doncic for the win. Oh yeah!
Luka is straight up a cuss word in Boston. All right, what's the next 5-star play? Oh, it's an assist by Luka. All right, let's see.
Midpoint of the third quarter. Dallas down by
13. Oh.
Behind the back again, and a slam dunk by Cauley Stein.
This is so nice.
Dallas down by 13. Behind the back again, and a slam dunk by Cauley Stein.
So nice. All right. What's the next 5-star play? Oh, a 3-pointer by Luka. This looks familiar.
Finney Smith to inbound. Back to Doncic. Doncic pulls up, 3-pointer. Bang! Bang! It's good! Doncic wins the game at the buzzer!
So basically, if there's 1 second left on the clock, or less, and Luka has the ball on the left wing, you were gonna lose. That's the theme I'm sensing here. And now Josh Reeves gets a 5-star play. Okay. What?
13 years in Europe, one of the great European point guards, 4 in the NBA, yep. And always, always a quarterback on the floor.
Oh, it goes in!
I mean, that was a great shot. And I do love Josh Reeves. 5-star? I don't know. 5 stars? Who's to say? What's the next? Oh, a dunk by Luka. All right. What happened here?
To get this foul early, so you, if you Luka, or if you're Hardaway, you got to make them take the foul early, so you have enough time in the shot clock to run the second play.
Doncic
down to 8, moves on, Pomo tilts it in, hammers it home. Dallas has got the lead. Doncic throws.
I remember this play, but I do not remember that much force. Holy cow.
Down to 8. Moves on. Pomo
tilts it in. Hammers it home. Dallas has got the lead. Doncic throws down a sledgehammer.
Don't sleep on Luka.
And you see Coop, my favorite part of the play. Coop right over Dirk's shoulder, just losing his mind.
Don't sleep on Luka.
Oh my gosh. What a dunk. What a dunk. All right. What's the next one?
Luka against Austin Rivers. Brings it down towards a minute to play in the first quarter. Luka with a step up from the baseline.
Oh, just no need. No need to do it. But you know what? Why not? I don't have to do it, but I'm gonna. Oh, this is a good one. I remember this one.
Right before Thanksgiving.
Indeed.
Got it.
Here in the corner, Luka. Goes in. How did he do it? How did he do it? That is Luka magic.
Yeah, this is the origin of Luka magic, right? Like, that's the first time that it was ever said out loud, I think, on broadcast television.
Before Thanksgiving.
Indeed.
Got it.
Here in the corner, Luka. Goes in. How did he do it? How did he do it? That is Luka magic.
Incredible.
Scraping paint off the ceiling.
Just absurd. This is fun. How many more of these are there? Oh, there's only a few more. Okay. I want to watch the rest of these. That's all right. This is a fun trip through time. Now I don't want to get emotional on the TL, but this is a Dennis Smith Jr. highlight. So I'm going to need a second to gather myself before we watch this Dennis dunk. Okay, I'm ready.
Saturday, he missed it in our pregame. Wild with Dallas against the Wizards. He's averaged 22 a game. Here he goes. 360.
Get to come.
I love you, Dennis. I hope you're having a great time in Portland. I think he is. He's playing a lot. They're winning some games. Oh, and look at the face on the bench. We got Salah Mejri. We got a very young looking Dwight Powell. Of course, Mavs great Jalen Jones, Kyle Collinsworth, the legendary Yogi Ferrell. Is this McBob? I think this might be Josh McRoberts here, if memory serves. And now looking down. Man, this is tough. Who is that looking down? Would that be Doug McDermott? Is that McBuckets? Oh, is that JJ? JJ Barea? That's JJ, right? Yeah, JJ. Okay. Yeah, this is an iconic team. Iconic team. Now, I've agreed with every five-star rating so far, but I have to say, if you're going to consider this dunk a five-star and you're not going to include his dunk against Portland in the five-star club, I don't know. I'm all for giving Dennis a five-star rating, but his self alley-oop off the floor against Portland, that is easily his best dunk in Dallas. So, I don't know. I'm happy Dennis got some shine, but I think it was the wrong dunk that was included.
0.5, they'll get off a good shot.
And Smith trying to get the ball into Barnes. Barnes to bring the buzzer. He banked it in. Mavericks have won it. What an improbable win for Harrison Barnes and the Mavericks.
It's an even younger looking Dwight Powell. Holy moly. What a shot.
They'll get off a good shot.
And Smith trying to get the ball into Barnes. Barnes to bring the buzzer. He banked it in. Mavericks have won it. What an improbable win for Harrison Barnes and the Mavericks.
Dennis, look at Dennis. I don't know what he's saying or what he's doing, but I love it. About to go grab some lunch, man. Hey, thanks for watching. Appreciate you, man. Have a good lunch. Yeah, so that was great. And that was a much needed win too, because I think the Mavs, they were like 2-13 or something, or like 2-15. It's nice to get a win. Oh, this is a Jonathan Motley game winner. Malik Wayans, that's a name I haven't heard in a long time.
That's what Dallas is going to do is Wayans tries. He goes to Motley.
Jonathan Motley has 3 5-star plays.
Well, it's good. You
know, okay.
You talk to him, he's not happy he went ninth. That's going to be... Oh!
Nothing but net. My guy, Jonathan Motley. This was a fun summer league, by the way. Summer league 2017, I was at this one. The Mavs went all the way to the semifinals. They lost to the Lakers. Lakers shot like 80% in the first half of that game. Excuse me. Yeah, that was a fun summer league. Now this is an iconic game winner.
And here's Motley. Little handoff for Ding. Ding's driving, trying to spin.
For the win.
He Motley does it. With 3/10 remaining.
Now, why is that so iconic? First off, nearly a buzzer beater. Second off, Ding was involved in the play. Third, this won the Summer League Championship for the Mavs. And fourth, this was the final year of the Orlando Summer League, which means the Mavs are forever champions of the Orlando Summer League. All right, it looks like we got 5 more. What is this?
There's my guy.
And that did not look good. There's your basket.
Whoa.
There's my guy.
And that did not look good.
Oh my God. Dude. What? What?
There he is. There's my guy.
And that did not look
good. Oh my God.
Everybody. And that did not look good. There's your guy. Everybody hates the rim right now. There's your guy. Dwight Powell.
My guy.
And that did not look good.
Good Lord. I did not remember this play at all. Jeez, dude.
There's my guy.
And that did not look
good.
Oh, that is Zach LaVine, isn't it? And Taj Gibson too, I think, right? I do not remember this play at all. I'm very ashamed that I don't remember. This is unbelievable. Jeez, that is straight up Blake Griffin. I mean, that was unbelievable. Also, fantastic Mavs team too. The cutaway to the bench where you see JaVale McGee and Raymond Felton, that's 2 all-time great Mavs. And I mean that very seriously. I love Raymond Felton. This was...
There's my guy.
And that did not look
good. Good Lord. What a dunk. That's a appropriate 5-star play. I agree with that one. All right, this is... We're about to get really emotional in here.
8 seconds. Dirk against Randall.
Let's get out of here.
Dirk with the shot. And with 2.1, that's how far we are from getting out of here.
That's what he does.
Against.
Does he have it?
Between the two. Well, he's got to admire that from the bench.
Well, you got experience against a young player in Randall. Dirk getting exactly the shot that he wanted. I see a little bounce to the baseline and a pull-up against one of the greatest players ever to play the game.
And there you go.
There you go. That's greatness. Appreciating greatness is what it is.
There's 3 quarters. The fourth quarter. Kobe didn't play tonight in what was billed as the final matchup between the two.
Mm. Great shot. Great exchange on the bench. Also, underrated element of this play and the whole reaction to it is as Dirk goes back in the bench, he turns around to look for Kobe, but he looks at Tariq Black first, and he responds by looking at Dirk like he's about to like beat him up, basically. Like I think he thought Dirk was trying to show them up, but no, he was just hanging out with his buddy Kobe.
Greatest players ever to play the game.
And you can even see him, like, he starts to like take a step toward Dirk too. You see that? Watch this. Like, he kind of like, that's just a, who's this? Oh yeah, that is Meta. Yeah. Chopper, you're trying to stop my heart, man. Thank you for the coffee. All right, so we got four more. All right, and they're all from This is the early days.
Harris goes into Darren Williams.
Now, that play was significant for a couple reasons. First off, it's a buzzer beater. It was a double overtime game. The game literally would never end. I believe the Mavs had a back-to-back the next night, if I'm not mistaken. And to further complicate things, or I guess to sweeten the pot even more, former Mavs great Rajon Rondo, you can see him standing right here on the bench. It wasn't this play. It was a different play in the game. Was caught on camera trying to trip Darren Williams, like, in the middle of a play. Now, he gets out of his way here, but earlier in the game, he legitimately stuck his leg out to try and trip Darren Williams while he was in the middle of a play. So, really, really classic example of what makes Rajon Rondo such a great player and why he was so important to the Mavs.
Harris goes into Darren Williams. They will catch a flight!
Wonderful moment. Wonderful moment. Darren Williams, the boxer nowadays. That's right. Yeah, he's about to fight Frank Gore, I think. That's going to be wild. All right, so I agree. That's a five-star play. That's a five-star play. And in fact, that's the most recent true buzzer beater game winner at home for the Mavs. Darren Williams, 2016. All right, Devin Harris. Now, I am going to be honest with you. I do not remember this play. This is December 4th, 2015. Mavs versus Rockets.
By James Harden at the cup. Rockets were up 12. Dirk with a shot. Then Harris, a circus shot. At the cup. Rockets were up 12. Dirk with a shot. Then Harris at the cup.
Really good, strong basketball play by Pat Beverly to just waylay Devin Harris in the middle of the floor like that. Really, really nicely done.
Rockets were up 12. Dirk with a shot.
Like,
then at the cup.
What is he doing?
Rockets were up 12, Dirk with a shot, then Harris.
That's like a flagrant five, dude. Great shot. A five-star play, I don't know.
Rockets were up 12, Dirk with a shot, then Harris, a circuit.
But the Mavs are wearing the green jerseys, so I think that it definitely gets an extra star just because of the green jerseys. Now, if memory serves, this was also the night, I think the Rockets won this game pretty comfortably. I think this was the night where Trevor Ariza reportedly tried to fight Salim Ejri in the tunnel after the game. this is the Mavs glory days for sure. This is the glory days. Great shot by Devin Harris. Truly no idea what Pat Bev is doing here. I don't know. Very, very strange sequence of events. Yeah, a lot of all-time great Mavs on the floor for this one. Who won? So if this is the game I'm thinking of, the Rockets ended up winning this game by like 30. I could pull it up though. Let's see. This is what, December 4th, 2015. That would be the next season, you big dummy. The Rockets won this game by 4. Okay, so that must have been a different game against Houston. Must have been a different season entirely. Mavs only lost this game by four, so that's cool. Yeah, five stars? I don't know. It's the green jerseys, though, so I'll say that's fine. Five-star play. Oh, no, I mean between Sal and Ariza. They luckily they didn't engage in any hand-to-hand. It was just a verbal exchange. All right, so this is Devin Harris. Another Devin Harris play. Okay, five-star play against the Nets, February 28th, 2015. Nice. Left in the quarter, half court heat, Devin Harris. Five left in the quarter, half court heat, Devin Harris. Devin Harris wearing number 20 on this play. Remember, there was a couple years in the middle there where he did wear number 20, and then when the Mavs traded him to Denver, he came back to Dallas, wore number 34 again. So that's kind of like the 45 era for Michael Jordan, was Devin Harris wore 20. And now the final play on this list, the final five-star play for the Mavs is by this guy named Monte Ellis. They're playing a game in Milwaukee. And now if you're very young, you might not remember Monte Ellis. But if you're a real one, then you know all about Monte, all about what he has and how much of it that he has and what he represents and how awesome he is. And so this play was sensational.
Don't foul him, though.
Now, was it a travel? I mean, I remember watching this in like 5,000 frames per second slow motion after the game. This was not a travel. It was the correct call to let them play on. I just had something in my mouth. It was correct play to, or correct call to not call it a travel. Even so, it does look a little dubious. But Monte drains the shot, and this was the beginning of the 14-15 season when the Mavs were smoking everybody. One of the few close games they played during that run, and Monte hits this epic game winner.
Don't foul him. Ellis,
and he hit that, I believe that's former Mavs great OJ Mayo here, and now to add to the drama, this is current Mavs head coach Jason Kidd right here. You might remember him from the Mavs. And I also believe that this man right here is future Mavs assistant coach Jared Dudley. And I also believe this guy is future Mavs center Zaza Pachulia. So all sorts of layers. At least I think that's Jared Dudley. Let me rewind here. Let me see how he moves. Yeah, that's 100% just Jared Dudley. So a lot of Mavs connections here. Former Mav OJ Mayo, future Mav Jared Dudley, Jason Kidd, Zaza Pachulia. Someone said Carlos Delfino on the bench. That's a name I haven't heard in a long time. The big question is, why isn't Giannis in the game? I guess this is maybe before Giannis was Giannis. But even still, that's Jared Bayless by the looks of it. Wow. Really a who's who. Nice jerseys, too. I had forgotten that they wore those jerseys that far into the future. So there it is. That's all the five-star plays in Clip Pro's history. Nice stuff.